The Case of the Ferris Wheel Caper with Mike McKay, Private Eye. Today, Chapter 3, Where's Barney? Detective Bungalupper was long overdue in arriving on the case. But though he didn't know it, he was on his way.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, what am I going to do? I'm late. Mike will be mad. Oh, what did I see? I do believe a train is passing by. Good morning, little train. Hurry, please, because I'm late. Move on. I got to cross the track. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. A big airplane right in the middle of the park. I better help these fellows move it out. Okay, man. Contact. We got to get this thing out of here. Here we go. This thing doesn't want to go. Oh, got a good idea. I'll push from behind here. Okay, man, whenever you're ready, let her go. This ain't gonna get us nowhere neither. Man, this thing is heavy. Hey, the wheel's stuck. Oh, boy, oh, boy. Come on, let's get out of here. Come on, move on. I'm in a hurry. Hello there, Uncle Bruce.
Come here. Do you realize that we've been waiting for 2.5 hours for you? We've got a case to solve. Now, come on, let's get to work. p.m. All activity proceeding normally. The park, bathed in the warm afternoon sun, was enjoying a good day. Made another check of the park residents. They all checked out okay. With nothing more to do till evening, we stopped to watch Mr. O'Harris, who was busy training a new act for his animal show. While he worked patiently with a little pony, he told us some interesting things about the training of animals. It was an interesting lesson, and the afternoon passed quickly. Not far away, a certain young lady was very busy with a project of her own. Susie the chimp had apparently found an old set of keys and was now attempting to let herself out of her cage. She failed with the lock, but Mr. O'Harris took pity on her and let her out to play for a while. As always, she provided lots of entertainment without even really trying. Guessed that an old plastic bucket could be so much fun. But evening shadows were beginning to lengthen now across the park. It was time for us to talk over our plans for the night watch at the Ferris wheel. We finally agreed that Barney would take the first watch while Mike and I went home to get some rest.
I guess I better check everything out here to see that there's nothing fishy going on. Looks pretty good. Nothing hiding. Oh, be careful there, Mr. Foot. I may need you later. Well, it's going to be a long night. I wonder if I could just take a little nap, maybe. Hey, there's a good place up there in that Ferris think anything's gonna happen for a while. Still pretty early. I'll just crawl up there and rest for a little bit. Let the rest of the whale fellas go home from work. That's what I'll do. Oh, this is gonna be nice. Oop, careful there now. I'll rock myself to sleep.
Don't miss tomorrow's chapter in the case of the Ferris Wheel Caper. The Mysterious Hand. p.m. Detective Barney Bungalupper had fallen asleep on the job. While not far away, a mysterious figure was hard at work. 11:59 p.m. A hand reached for the controls of the Ferris wheel. But Barney still slept on. 11:59 p.m. Suddenly, the wheel was in motion. The mysterious culprit had struck again, without even being seen, and was still at large. Detective Bungalupper was trapped on the spinning wheel, with no one to help him until morning.
Oh, what's going on here? Oh, hey, somebody stop this thing! Help! Help! Oh, my goodness! Help! Help! Uncle Bruce! Little Mike! Somebody turn this thing off!
Don't miss Chapter 5 in the Case of the Ferris Wheel Caper.